Justice League, just dessert served without a high. When Zack Snyder of Batman vs. Superman fame stepped down midway after a personal tragedy, and Joss Whedon, who helmed the Avengers, took it to its completion, one would have imagined that a super-duper superhero movie would be the outcome. But although Snyder gets solo credit as director and Whedon finds his name in the writing department, their joint effort is pretty much a super dud. It doesn't go anywhere near Warner Brothers' last release, Wonder Woman, which still stands way up on a pedestal. It saved the world time once again. The latest threat to our world is fierce Steppenwolf, who calls himself End of the World. He leads a pack of parademons who feed on fear, and he's here to get his hands on hidden mother boxes for ultimate power. Superman is dead, so Bruce Wayne, alias Batman, whose superpower is that he's super rich, traverses the earth to put together a lineup of superheroes. After due introductions and stories for each, Superwoman or Diana of the Amazons, protector of those who can't fight, Barry Allen, The Flash, Cyborg, Vincent Stone, and Atlantean Aquaman are all brought on board. The film holds thus far, especially when Aquaman makes his presence felt. There's quite a bit of fun out there too, as punchlines and cheeky put-downs fly around as fast as a hero's fist. But this script can't do without Superman, even if actor Henry Cavill is cast with rock-like expressions and girlfriend Amy Adams is, well, just a girlfriend around him. Pretty soon there's a takeover by the computer graphics department. Special effects pummel heroes and evil forces endlessly. The unending climax where good finally triumphs over evil is a classic example of overkill by CGI and no-show by the writers. Barry Allen as The Flash carries a whiff of young student Spidey from Captain America's Civil War with the same eager enthusiasm and non-stop chatter. So even that stuff borrowed from Marvel isn't refreshing. Two actors out of the ensemble are watchable. Superwoman Gal Gadot is taut, trim and still warm, especially around Bruce Wayne. Jason Momoa's tattoos and biceps make him interesting material for a solo show soon. Good news also comes with the credit scenes. It's obvious that Superman is still around, but Lex Luthor has broken free from jail, so the template for the next Superman vs. Luthor is ready. But for the moment, for a film that has nothing super new to show, Justice League gets a 2-star rating.